This year's Soccer Aid is being launched this morning, and to mark its 15th anniversary, would you believe, famous faces like Usain Bolt, Ollie Mears and Wayne Rooney as well are going to be returning to the pitch to raise money for UNICEF. Joining them, former Love Islander Kem Cetinany, who's hoping for another goal like this. That was Kem's goal in 2019. that was every boy's dream. Every girl's dream as well, I think.
It was, but I know how much stick I'm going to get in the boys' group chat for that video coming out again 2 years later. But do you know what? I happily admit that that was the best moment of my life.
Like, fantastic.
Any young boy growing up loving football to go and play in a game like that with all your childhood heroes and that to happen, I'd be lying if I didn't
fantastic.
Say it was the best moment ever.
Who were you most in awe of? You know, when you're in that dressing room and you're sort of, you know, putting on your shoes and getting sorted and you're looking up at all these amazing people.
Do you know what? The whole experience was a bit mental itself. But Usain Bolt, definitely, because I think he was taller than I realised.
Like, he's a big lad.
He's huge.
He's a big
so
fit
tall.
Lad.
And I don't know, like, I never really get a chance to see these people before. And just seeing him there and, like, him just chilling and watching him train, it was pretty mental experience. And obviously Rooney as well
of
this
course,
year.
Yes.
He's like a hero of mine as well. So do you know what? The whole experience is amazing. And the fact that we get to do it and raise so much money, it's the best day of the year for me.
It's fantastic. And it's been going for 15 years, which is amazing. What about you've got to be very careful because you have to watch you don't get injured. How's the training?
I'm a walking problem at the moment for some reason. I keep getting injured. I don't know, I'm only 25. I'm like a cripple. No, last couple of years I have had a few injuries, but hopefully this year I'll be all right, you know. The most important part, obviously, is raising money. But for me, if I can't play, it does ruin the excitement a bit. But I'll be all right this year.
So. I hope so. You've got to go and score. No pressure.
Let's hope so.
No pressure, but you've got to do another one. Now, look, Love Island is going to be back. Yeah. Probably not quite as we know it. There'll be differences, I would imagine. You'll be commentating on the show.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I host the podcast every day. I love it, you know. Like, it's been 4 years since I was on the show. I feel like a veteran now,
for
Lorraine.
For goodness sake. So you're going to be... I was going to say a blow-by-blow account, but maybe that's not the thing to say
genuinely
about Love Island. But do you have advice for the new contestants? Because you know what it's like being in there and then, much more importantly, coming out.
Yeah, do you know what? I've been on it 4 years ago. I'm around it every year, so I am used to it. But do you know what? I always just say to people, try and enjoy it.
Yeah.
Because I know it sounds quite cliche, but it's just a bit of fun. And I think if you overthink it, sometimes it can become more complicated than it needs to be.
Sure.
It is just young people having a laugh. Everyone's kind of just having fun, really. That is all it is. If I went on it now, I don't think I'd enjoy it as much.
Do you know?
Because I think I'd take it too serious. When I went on there, I was only just turned 21.
Yeah.
So it was a bit more
so
fun.
So don't
then.
Overthink it. Don't go in there with a plan. Just take it as
it's
it
is. It's great. They'll have the summer of their lives, I'm sure.
I bet they will.
They really will.
So absolutely no regrets for you doing that show because it's led to so many things. The most important thing, I would imagine, you're an ambassador for mental health charities. Mm. And that's hugely important for you. And, you know, you can actually... Young people will listen to you.
Yeah, I'll be honest, Lorraine. When I went on the show, I was still battling my own demons when I went on the show. And I think coming out gave me a chance to be able to have a platform, talk to people. It gave me more chance to figure out where I could get help and advise other people. And yeah, I'll be honest, I have no regrets whatsoever. I think it changed my life in many ways for the better. Of course, it pushed me into an industry I'd never been in before so fast. But it was great. Like, I can't complain. It's been amazing.
No. I mean, you've done things like you did Dancing on Ice. You've done that. You're doing MasterChef, I believe.
Yeah.
Now, you can cook. You know about food, don't you?
I don't know if I can cook, Lorraine, I'll be honest. Put it this way, I went on there not having a clue. Like, all I could do is, like, put pizzas and nuggets.
But you look so cute in the outfit. You look great as a
penny. That doesn't really make a difference. I'll be honest, all I'm going to say is on the first day, I pretty much had a breakdown in the middle of the studio.
Oh.
Genuinely, it's so hard.
Yeah, it's hard, overwhelming.
Like, if they put, like, a chicken in front of you, how am I meant to know how to open it up? Like, would you know? Okay,
I wouldn't know.
You wouldn't even know either.
I couldn't do MasterChef. I can't. I'm not allowed in the kitchen.
And it's got all
I'm
the
so
stuff
bad.
Inside.
I know it's minging. I know. I hear you. But you're also, though, right now, working real hard within a restaurant. You're opening a restaurant. What kind of grub?
Yeah, so I'm opening like a fine dining grill restaurant in Essex. Something I never really thought I'd get into. Yeah, I've got a family friend who's got restaurants and we've done it together.
Good
and
for you.
We're building a huge, huge restaurant in Essex, like 400 seats. And I know it's really random, but it's something I've always been passionate about. And it gave me a chance in lockdown to knuckle down. Bought the pub like 2 years ago.
It's brilliant.
Now we're here, we're opening in like 3 weeks, so it is pretty surreal.
That's great. Good for you.
Thank you.
Because that's hard. It's very really, hard. Really tough. You have to work your butt off, don't you? It's the hardest you've ever worked in your life.
Do you know what? I have to say, coming from doing TV and stuff, then going to actual, probably real business
yes,
now, I understand
absolutely,
why sometimes people...
Absolutely. But... Now, look, with all, you know, you did Love Island a wee while ago, but are you in touch with any of them? I mean, I know you and Amber had a wee thing.
You
had a wee
you
thing.
You always ask me the same question, Lorraine.
I do. But are you in touch, still mates with quite a lot of them in the
Yeah, do you know what? I'm friends with a lot of them.
Are they going to come along and see you playing soccer? That would be
yeah,
great.
Yeah, of course. And do you
can
know
people
what?
Go? Can are you
yeah,
going to have
course,
a bit
of course, people
outreach?
Can buy tickets. And that's
Excellent.
What I think makes it special this year, is that
Look
last year...
Look at you as a child there. I just saw a wee picture of you flashing up as a baby.
Oh, but there. I knew you'd get this photo.
You're only
again,
a wee
Lorraine.
Thing. Look at you there. A young, innocent child.
No, bless her. We are still friends, you know. I know
good.
You ask every time I come
no,
on
it's
in the rain. You're like our matchmaking mama.
I know. Well, we just, you know, we wanted to see it work out, but it doesn't matter. It's fine. As long as you're still pals.
No, we
and
are.
And they'll be there to see you and to see you play, which is going to be such a good
yeah,
thing.
And
you've gone global. You've gone global, haven't you? I mean, thanks to your mum, with you're going to be with your fashion thing all over the world.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
So yeah,
it's all going on.
I know. Do you know what? There's a lot going. Now you say this, there's a lot going on.
There's football. There's cooking. There's fashion.
I don't know where to
there's
stop.
Restaurants. Is there actually four or five of you?
Well, at this rate, I feel like there needs to be. Yeah, I brought out a clothing collection, my third one. With Primark, and it went all over the world, so we've got it in pretty much most stores. And my mum's a fashion designer, so she helped me design it.
Happy days.
And do you know what? It's
good
such a proud moment for her. I love getting her involved. You know, she's retired now. She's so good at what she does, and she helped me. And people love it. People love the clothes. So it is mad. Somehow I've ended up in fashion, Lorraine. I'm going to start having to do a fashion segment on here.
Well, okay, that's a good idea. Why don't we do that? Because people are always saying do more boys' fashion.
Do you reckon?
Right, you're on.
All right, we'll
you're
do it. On. We'll do a one-off, see
it's
how we
happening.
Get on.
It's happening. Thank you, lovely
Kem.
It's always a joy to see you. And Soccer Aid is going to take place Saturday the 4th, right, of September. And tickets, as Kem says, are available now for a fantastic cause. Don't forget, you can watch full episodes of Lorraine on the ITV Hub and all the best clips, compilations and playlists right here on our channel. Just subscribe now and you'll never miss an upload. Click here to watch another video similar to this one, or click here to head to our channel's homepage to explore all of our exciting videos.